Hi guys. A lot of times the operators of children's home have one difficulty, that is to admit right kind of children. They do this mistake because they perhaps do not understand what is children's home under the JJ Act. So I'm going to use one analogy to explain to you, to help you to understand what is children's home in JJ Act. Children's home is part of seven different kinds of homes. They are collectively called as child care institutes. So children's home is one among them, and this children's home is supposed to take care of children that needs care and protection. So how you have to look at this children's home is like a hospital. Now let's look at this. If I have a sickness, only I'll go to see a doctor, right? And when I go to see the doctor has two choices to make. Should I treat this individual at home by giving him some medicine, or should I admit? Likewise, when a child is presented to you as an operator of a children's home, you have a choice to make whether to send this child home with the required assistance that you can render, or you can admit the child into the children's home. Let's say, for example, you have made a decision that this child requires admission to the children's home. Just like in the hospital, doctor would run certain tests to determine if this individual requires hospitalization. So you have to use the diagnostic tool called child in need of care and protection. There are 12 different categories that you have to run one by one to see if at least one of them sticks. If they do, then they meet the criteria for admission to the children's home. Now, patient is admitted to the hospital. What does the doctor do? He visits the patient every day to see if the patient is making progress. Likewise, once the child is admitted to the children's home, you will have to monitor this child's progress on a monthly basis on a document called individual care plan. So once the patient makes adequate amount of progress, the doctor tells the patient, look, you're fine now, you can go home. Likewise, if your individual care plan tells you that this child has reached a potential or a threshold that you could reintegrate back into the society, then you will help this child to get back into the society. So before this child gets before the patient gets discharged, what does the doctor do? Doctor makes sure that the patient understands the discharge instructions and follows up with the child, follows up with the patient. Likewise, as a children's home operator, you will give certain discharge instructions. You want to help the child to understand why you are sending them home, what you want them to do to remain at home, and what you want them to give you as follow-up information. So if you understand this analogy of a hospitalization of a patient to admission of a child to a children's home, it is so much easier. Remember, a patient never admitted to the hospital to stay there forever. Likewise, child should never be admitted to the children's home to stay there forever, to spend their entire childhood. That is an injustice. If the child does require, despite your individual care plans show that he or she needs to stay in the children's home, so be it. But if you don't do individual care plan, and if you just assume that the child has been granted admission, so I'm going to take care of this child till the child reaches 18, is violation of that child's right. I hope this video is of help to you. If you enjoy this video, please give me a like, share it, comment on it, and please do write me your questions pertinent to adoption and JJ Act. Till we meet again, goodbye.